Around the 4th century CE, a man named Asanga was born in the northwestern part of the Indian subcontinent, in a place called Purushapura, now known as Peshawar in modern Pakistan. Supposedly born the son of a Kshatriya father and a Brahmin mother, Asanga is believed to have originally been a member of the Mahishasaka school, one of the many early Buddhist schools which had dominated following the death of the Buddha. However, as he grew older, Asanga became disillusioned with the teachings of the early Buddhist sects, in particular the teaching of no-self, and converted to Mahayana Buddhism. It is tradition that in the depths of his despair, he went on a mystic journey and travelled to the place of Maitreya Bodhisattva, the future Buddha of this world, where he received several teachings that led to the development of Asanga's own system of Mahayana Buddhism. There is considerable scholarly debate as to whether or not the Maitreya of this story should be considered a mythical explanation of his own unique and original thought, likely influenced by some visionary experience he underwent in meditation, or whether there is a historical teacher, which some scholars term Maitreyanatha, whom he received aspects of his new system of thought from. Regardless of whether it was due to his own thoughts or the teachings of a master, Asanga went on to become an immensely influential teacher in the Mahayana tradition, establishing the second great system of early Mahayana thought, called Yogacara. Yogacara, literally meaning yoga practice, emphasizes the study of perception and cognition. Central to this school is the concept of vinapti matra, which means representation only. This is an extremely contentious area of scholarship when it comes to interpreting and translating exactly what Asanga and Yogacara more broadly means when they discuss this concept. Asanga himself used the term in his text, the Mahayana Samgraha, or Compendium of Mahayana. He states, "These representations, vinyapti, are mere representations, vinyapti matra. This is because there is no corresponding thing/object, artha. Just as in dreams, they appear even without a thing or object, just in the mind alone. Forms, images of all kinds of things, objects, like visibles, sounds, smells, tastes, tangibles, houses, forests, land, and mountains, and yet there are no such things that all in this place." Some scholars argue that this is a clear statement of an idealist conception of reality. This conception has been popular with outsiders, both modern academics and historic Buddhist and Brahminical critics. In this conception, Yogacara is proposing that there is nothing outside of the mind itself, and that the world beyond is merely a construction of said mind. Others have suggested that this is instead a realistic pluralist conception of reality. Instead of rejecting a physical reality beyond the mind, Yogacara is instead suggesting that we only have the representation of the world as reported by our senses, rather than an accurate one-to-one report of reality as it truly is. Finally, yet others still reject the realist-idealist divide, suggesting that it is better to understand Yogacara as dealing purely with the issue of cognition and the projection of consciousness and creation of the cognitive objects by the mind. This line of argument goes down that the process of cognitive creation is intrinsically linked to appropriation. I can only own something if it is an object to be owned. And in this sense, ownership is intrinsically linked to the self. Something can only be owned if there is an I to own. Therefore, such thinkers argue that vinyapti matra is actually referring to the transcendental idealism, and that it is not making a metaphysical argument, but rather pointing towards a path of liberation. At this point, I will mention that we should be careful not to project too many Western positions onto a late classical Indian philosopher, namely in that his goal, liberation, is fundamentally different to certain classical and post-classical Western aims of inquiry, and that furthermore, it is difficult to find one-to-one translations for other concepts from the matrix of Indian thought, which are so important to understanding Asanga's worldview, such as karma and samsara. Karma, in particular, is important to understand the Yogacara worldview, in particular the role that karma plays within the mental realm. Previous Buddhist schools had posited that the mental realm was impacted by the six senses, which in Buddhist psychology consisted of the five common senses, sense of smell, sense of taste, touch, sight and hearing, as well as a sense of mind. However, Yogacara put forth a further two senses, the deluded or defiled consciousness and the storehouse of consciousness. The deluded consciousness, called the Klistamanas is so called because this is that aspect of the mind which creates and clings to the ideas of self and individuality. However, the object which this defiled consciousness clings to is the eighth component of sensory system, the so-called storehouse of consciousness, which exists below the threshold of consciousness proper. This subliminal consciousness, called the Alaya Vijnana, is the repository of all the past tendencies, actions, and karma of the individual. As such, this includes all the past memories and accumulation of previous greed, hatred, attachment, and delusion. But it is more than just a barrel where the past is kept. It forms a substrate upon which all other cognition occurs. Because of this, it carries the karmic legacies of previous actions and constantly interacts with active consciousness, causing the perpetuation of the deluded and defiled cognitions which led to attachment, aversion, and ignorance in the first place. Thus, with the addition of the deluded consciousness and the storehouse of consciousness, Asanga developed a psychological theory of karma and how it perpetuates the cycle of suffering. So having examined Yogacara's theory of reality and mentality, it is important to examine the three natures, which is Asanga's theory of experience. The three natures represent the one reality, but viewed from three distinct perspectives: the appearance, the process, and the emptiness of the same apparent entity. The first form, or nature, is the fully conceptualized nature. This is the imaginary or constructed perspective where through language, attachment, and the world is divided between conceptual objects, the so-called divide between the perceived and the perceiver. This is the mode of everyday life of unenlightened people, which is, according to Yogacara, false and empty. This perspective attributes intrinsic existence to things and leads to a mind of grasping. The second form is the other dependent nature, which is the causal flow of phenomena which is confused by everyday people with the fully conceptualized nature. This interdependent flow of arising and decay appears to bring about objects and subjects, but in reality, these supposedly independent things are like illusions since they have no standalone existence. Even by accepting the dependent arising of objects, at this stage we are still conceptualizing it, even if only as a non-dual flow of impressions only. The third form is the fully accomplished nature, which is when the practitioner experiences the true nature of things through meditation and yogic practice. This leads to a point where the practitioner cognizes but is absent of all the concepts which clouded the other two forms of experience. The three natures is also closely tied to the Yogacara understanding of shunyata, or emptiness, which is of paramount importance in the Madhyamaka tradition of Nagarjuna. In Yogacara, this emptiness is the absence of duality, between physical and non-physical, self and other, which is falsely created when we conceptualize the world into what is and what is not, rather than the causal flux of interdependent origination. This emptiness further extends to the false divide between the external and internal, subject and object, the false separation of mentality, which is in reality an interconnected causal stream of consciousness. The major difference between Yogacara and Madhyamaka emerges here. Yogacara posits that both shunyata, as in emptiness, and consciousness must exist. Their argument is that even if consciousness is empty and unreal, it does exist, and that it is only logical to speak of emptiness if there is something that is empty. On the other hand, Madhyamaka would refuse to even posit these two positions, leading Asanga and later Yogacara practitioners to criticize Madhyamaka as being nihilistic. However, we must also remember that Asanga did not create this complex psychology as a game or to pass time, but rather in the tangible pursuit of liberation from worldly suffering. With this goal in mind, one of the most influential aspects of Asanga's writings was the laying down of a path from everyday practice to enlightenment through the five paths and the 10 stages, or bhumis, on the Bodhisattva path of awakening. As the name of the tradition suggests, Yogacara is focused on meditative practice. This practice is central to the radically transformative process of overturning the cognitive biases of conceptualization, which Yogacara identifies as the root of attachment and grasping. Ideally, as the practitioner progresses along the paths, they will overturn their everyday commonplace conceptual view of seeing the world and adopt the so-called great mirror cognition, or Mahadarshana Jnana, which sees and reflects things as they are without bias or distortion. Asanga and Yogacara went on to be extremely important in both the Tibetan and East Asian branches of Buddhism. Virtually all schools of Mahayana East Asian Buddhism come to rely on Yogacara explanations in the creation of their own doctrine. However, of direct importance to the Yogacara tradition was Asanga's conversion of his own half-brother, Vasubandhu, from the Sarvastivada sect of Buddhism. Vasubandhu would develop into one of the leading intellectual lights of the Gupta era in Indian history, and I will examine his influence on Indian and Buddhist thought in a separate video.